Okay guys, whenever we talk about academic writing task 1, there are four options. You don't have any option, but actually there are four categories. The first one is graph with a trend. Second one is comparative graph. Third one is process diagram. Fourth one is map. So we will do all four, okay? Now today we are going to discuss maps. Remember, when you were small, you used to play a game Spot the Difference. You know, two identical pictures, do tasveerein ek jaisi, spot the difference. Over here hat is red, their hat is green, right? Over here this and that and all that. In the same way, they will give you two maps of a city or town or a small place, and all you need to do, you need to spot those differences, and then you will write about those differences. You will write a report on that, okay? These two maps can be one in the past and one in present, right? Second, it can be both maps from the past. This is very, very important. If they give you one map 2001, second 2010. So now both are past, so you will use past tense for both. If there is one map that is like 2010 and today, for present, they will not use the word 2021. They will use today, or they will say now. 2010 and now, 2015 and now, it's just like that. Okay, now I'm going to read it from here. Please follow me. This type of question often shows you a plan of a city in two time periods, right? And you have to describe the main changes between the two periods. The most common time periods are between a time in the past and now, two times in the past. For example, 2000 and 2010. Is that clear? Yeah? All right. Now, next is the plan. We will go through these four bullet points. The first one is brief introduction to the maps in your own words. In a minute, I will show you how to do that. We will go into the detail of it. Brief introduction to the maps in your own words. Next, short overview to describe what has happened to the town in general. This is called overview. First paragraph, introduction. Second paragraph, overview. Next, two paragraphs to describe some of the main changes. This is what we call body of the report. So in total, how many paragraphs? Four paragraphs. Introduction, overview, and two paragraphs in body. Minimum 150 words and all that. Now let's take a look at this map here. The maps below show changes in the Spanish city of Castellón in recent times. Summarize the information by selecting and reporting the main features and make comparisons where relevant. Now please take a look, Castellón 2000. See, they didn't have any modern facilities and all that. And then Castellón today. In today, we have a hall of residence, police station, new shops, new train station, even airport under construction, new shopping center, cinema, bars, and all that. When they give you maps in actual exam, they will also give you directions. East, west, north, south. So you can easily write north corner or northwest corner, in the downtown, in the middle, east side, west side, and all that. So they will always give you directions so that you can just do that. You can link this with the map in IELTS listening. Okay, the language you can use like that. All right, now, please come to page number 112. And now you will move between page number 112 and page number 108. First, we are going to see how to write the introduction. The two maps show the main changes which have taken place in the town of Castellón between the year 2000 and today. That's it. Please come back to the map, and they have written, the maps below show changes in the Spanish city of Castellón in recent times. So all you need to do, you need to reword or paraphrase this sentence. Paraphrase means write it or rewrite it in your own words, and that will become your first introduction sentence. Is this clear? right? Now, let's go on. In general, it appears that, underline this phrase, in general, it appears that. You can use it in any overview. In general, it appears that Castellón has become a much more modern city, present perfect. Because they said now, for now you will use present perfect. For now you will not use present simple tense. You will use present perfect because changes have taken place. That is why. So Castellón has become a much more modern city with far more shopping and transport facilities. For shopping, they have shopping malls and supermarket. And for transport facilities, they have tram line, bike rental scheme, airport under construction and all that. You can add one more thing here. Please add it. With far more shopping, comma, transport and entertainment facilities. You know, clubs and bars and all that. So you can use entertainment facilities. Is this clear? Right? So this paragraph is called overview. First introduction, second overview. And you will follow this pattern for any map type of question. Now we have actually the details. So one interesting change is that, underline one interesting change is that. You can copy it in any map type of report. One interesting change is that a new tram line has been built. Now please take a look, go back to the map. And tram line has been built to connect the university with the town center. Look at university, look at town center. Can you see tram line?
Yes.
So they have started from there. And by the way, you may take a start from anywhere, but try to talk about some prominent change. Okay? All right. In 2000, now focus tenses. Focus the tenses. In 2000, there wasn't any accommodation. Past tense. Right? There wasn't any accommodation. By the way, wasn't is a contraction and contractions should be avoided. So you should write there was no accommodation. Instead of any, just write there was no accommodation for students. But a hall of residence has been built. Hall of residence. Yesterday we were talking about it. Hall of residence. A place to live. In listening, exactly. That's right. Hall of residence has been built. Has been built is passive voice of present perfect. So for maps, you should know past tense and present perfect tense passive voice. What is passive voice? Has been built. Banaya gaya hai. Right? It's like that. Okay, another striking change is that, underline this also, you will use it. Now tomorrow when you are writing your report, you will use these phrases. Another striking change is that, now after this, if you write a broken sentence, ye sentence aapke gale padega. You know what I mean? Examiner will say, okay, ye isne ratta laga liya, aage isko aata hi nahi kya likhna. But after that, if you write a grammatically correct sentence, iski bhi value ban jayegi. Okay, so another striking change is that the old market in the west of the city has been knocked down to make way for new shops. Now go back and see old market knocked down to make way for new shops. Can you see that? Now you will say map mein to kaha hi nahi dukane girani. Girainya to nahi bani hai na. Ya uske upar hi to nahi bana diya. So it's that. Has been knocked down. Which tense? Present perfect, not continuous, only present perfect. With present perfect continuous, we use ing. Okay? So has been knocked down and this is passive voice. Okay. A completely new covered market has also been built. Why completely new? Because there wasn't anything there. Exactly. So you will use phrases like that. A completely new covered market has been built on the other side of town. Now they did not mention east, west, north, south. Otherwise you will write on the south side, west side, north side and all that. Okay, so you will divide the whole map into two parts. You can just see like this vertically or horizontally divided into two parts. Or maybe you can just see transport facilities one part, entertainment facilities second part, shopping facilities third part, like that. Okay. If we look at the port area, now one paragraph about port area. It has been pedestrianized since 2000. Pedestrianized means now you can walk it only. Vehicles are not allowed. It has been pedestrianized since 2000. Has been pedestrianized. You see, present perfect passive voice is very common. And a range of entertainment facilities have been built. Now, what are those entertainment facilities? Cinema, bars, and clubs. So, range of entertainment. Now, instead of using the word cinema, bar, clubs, you have used the word entertainment, range of entertainment facility. This is what we call rewording, paraphrasing. So you'll get good Venn score. And if you write bar, cinema, and same wording, just see what sort of place is that. If this is supermarket, you say shopping facility. If this is train, you say transport facility. So you can use words like that. Okay, let's go on. The northeast of the city used to be a green area. Now they have mentioned northeast, so most definitely in actual exam they will give you directions. The northeast of the city used to be a green area with lots of trees, but the trees have been cut down. Clear? Trees have been cut down and a new shopping complex has been constructed. Now don't see someone is cutting down the trees in the map. Means jab darakht nahi hai to kat hi gaye na, right? So a new shopping complex has been constructed. Now just look at this sentence. They said northeast of the city used to be a green area. Past tense. Used to be means hua karta tha. Green area hua karta tha. With lots of trees, but the trees have been cut down. Trees have been cut down means in present perfect, right? And a new shopping complex has been constructed. A final interesting development, underline that also. Last sentence where you can use this. A final interesting development has been the introduction of a bike rental scheme in the city center. Clear? So this is how you will write your answer on maps. Let me tell you, just like in IELTS test, opinion essay and discussion essays are very, very common. The most common types are opinion and discussion. In the same way, for report writing, most common types are graph with a trend and comparative graph. Although we have four categories, but graph with a trend and comparative graph, I'll teach you that. They are most common ones. For letter writing, formal and informal letters are very, very important. Sometimes semi-formal, otherwise formal and informal. So you'll be getting this sort of map in actual test. And again, one thing. Please come to page number 112. Not 114. Okay, I'm here. Page number 114. The pictures illustrate the changes in ship's mouth between 1995 and 2010. Now, which years are they?
Past.
Both are past. 1995 and 2010. Summarize the information by selecting and reporting the main features and make comparisons where relevant. Now, for 1995, you will use past. And for 2010, even you will use past tense. Now you will not use present perfect tense, okay? Let me see if they have given any answer towards the end of the book. Passive voice? No, I have not passive voice. You can use passive voice. Okay, that is Kimsville. Kimsville is different. This is Shipmouth. Kimsville is here, but that is in present. So, you will be using total past tense. Listen, for 1995, you will use there used to be, hua karta tha. There used to be. For example, there used to be a factory there in 1995, which was replaced by a shopping center. Right? Which was replaced by a shopping center. Jisko shopping center se replace kar diya gaya. Clear? So used to be, and then you'll use like that. Okay. Yes, one more thing. We have this book IELTS. Do we have academic book also for this one? Have you given it to the students? Good. So we've got this book for, actually can't show the book on screen, but yeah, better.